Speaking at a meeting of the Cannabis Task Force on Tuesday, April 20th, Minister for Commerce Emma Hippolyte announced a six-month timeline for presenting a cannabis bill to Parliament. The bill forms a crucial part of the development of St. Lucia's cannabis industry. The minister reveals that there ought to be much public sensitization to ensure that the legislation is as comprehensive as possible, taking into account various social factors.
We believe the process, apart from having this draft bill, we have to continue the stakeholder discussion, especially the issue of education, how we protect minors. So we need to have a lot of community discussion apart from after we finish this document. So we see ourselves within a 6 months. The public education is key, and how we protect each other and things like that. That's what we see. We hope it's shorter than that, but that's what we see. A lot of public discussion.
Member of the Cannabis Task Force, Andrew DeCary, says there are multiple benefits to be derived from the full exploration of cannabis.
So it's almost a quarter of a century we've been looking forward to this day when we could produce a bill that would be able to free up our economy, get the youth back into agriculture, add to the GDP of the country. There are so many things that the sky is the limit with this particular plant, and in these particular times, when we're coming out of a COVID crisis and there's a war looming in the East, St. Lucia has to be able to stand on its own. We can't really depend on foreign countries to prop us up anymore. And real independence is food independence. So we believe that this agricultural project that we're about to embark on would be to the benefit of all St. Lucians, and we hope that the country could embrace it and change their attitudes towards the plant. It's not something that you need to fear, and that we could actually make a really good go at it and improve the lives of many people who have never had that pathway of upward social mobility.
President of the Ayanola Council for the Advancement of Rastafari, Empress Danny James, says the Rastafarian community looks forward to the establishment of a legal cannabis industry. She says that the Rastafarian community has been persecuted for its cannabis use, and having a seat at the table in the formation of a cannabis industry will ensure the advancement of the Rastafarian community in St. Lucia.
As the first Rastafari woman to head the organization, it is my job, which I am very happy to undertake to be part of that discussion. But even equally making me proud is where government has allowed us and recognized us, the Rastafari community, at this table where they would allow us to be part of, and where we now look forward to benefiting. Benefiting in a sense, over the years we have been marginalized, we have been denied, we have been jailed, we have gone through so much as a community just because of cannabis and marijuana and so much. And now we are here where we look forward to benefiting, where we look forward to being part of such a big step, a big moment. So we give thanks for being present. And in saying all that, with so much happening in the world now, and we speak of food security, I think coming now, cannabis would be the ideal crop to come in with food security, to strengthen food security. Well, the country will benefit, the communities, the rural communities will also benefit. Rastafari in general, we look forward to benefiting. So we give thanks to be here, we give thanks to be present, and we give thanks for the effort of the task force.
Public Relations Officer for the Cannabis Task Force, Vernie Manuel, says the task force is giving strong consideration to public health as the Cannabis Bill moves into the subcommittee phase.
We are anticipating that we will be able to complete the assignment of the task force within this financial year. We have agreed on the generalized framework, which continues from the original proposal, and we, in this current subcommittee phase, we are breaking out into specific areas of regulations, the medicinal licensing, and how the framework for the industry will develop in the coming months. The considerations are specifically with regard to public health and how to create a move from prohibition into permitted use. The public health framework, the education framework, how we move along the continuum of educating persons on the safe and sustainable use of cannabis and how we develop an industry in St. Lucia.
The Cannabis Task Force will be rolling out a public sensitization campaign on the road to presenting the Cannabis Bill to Parliament in the coming months. For the DBS News World, I am Jason Darius.